So, okay, dear students, today our class is on inverse trigonometric functions. Only one chapter you have in your class 12, plus 2 level, that is a trigonometric chapter, inverse trigonometric functions. And you have seen that there are a lot of applications in calculus and all that, because inverse trigonometric is a very important chapter in trigonometry. So, what is inverse trigonometric function? That is the first question. So, suppose for any value of x lies between minus 1 and 1, real number obviously, and sine theta, you have a relation sine theta is equal to x, then we may have infinitely many values of the angle theta which satisfy the equation sine theta equal to x. So let me draw a diagram. With the help of the diagram, you can understand the concept behind that. So suppose this is your x-axis and y-axis. So if you draw the sine curve, this is your sine curve, okay, this is your sine curve. Now suppose you have a relation that sine theta, I have written sine theta is equal to x. So this side you have theta and this side you are having x, because x is a function of theta, that is mentioned here. So for a given value of theta, you see, we have infinitely many values of angle theta which satisfy the equation sine theta is equal to x. So what is your x? X is between minus 1 and 1. X is between minus 1 and 1, because your range is, in general we write y is a function of x. In general we write y is a function of x, but here we have x equal to sine theta, or you can write for your clear understanding y is a sine x. Y is a sine x, I think that is the better approach for you. So if you write y is equal to sine x, then this is your y and this is your x. I hope it will be clear to you. So you see, you, what is the range of the sine function and cos function? Minus 1 to 1. So for any value of y, for any value of y that lies between minus 1 and 1. Suppose for half, I am taking y equal to half. So if you draw the y equal to half line, in how many points it will intersect the sine curve? Infinite number of points. So there are infinite number of values of x, because you have taken y is a function of x. So you see, there are infinite number of values of x for that half. So this is your actually, what is the whose sine value is half? Sine 30 degree is half. So you can say this is your pi by 6, and this is your again, you have some pi minus pi by 6. So you have this minus, this side negative, this side positive. So many values, 5 pi by 6, 3 pi by 6 and all that. So pi by 6 and multiple of pi by 6 will give you these values. So one observation is that for a particular value of x or particular value of y, that is y equal to half, you have infinite number of values of x. Once again I repeat, for a particular value of y, you have infinite number of values of x. So that is the language here, because you have written sine theta is equal to x. So we have infinitely many values of the angle theta which satisfy the equation sine theta equal to x. That is, sine of any one of these angles is equal to x. Okay. And if you write y equal to sine x, then x equal to sine inverse y. X equal to sine inverse y. So you see, sine x is a value and sine inverse x is an angle. Okay. You see, sine x is a value and sine inverse y is an angle. So in this case, sine of any one of these angles is equal to x. So angle theta is represented as sine inverse x. Therefore, sine inverse x represents an angle and the sine of this angle has the value x. So two important things I want to mention, that sine inverse x represents an angle while sine theta represents a Peon number. Sine inverse x represents an angle while sine theta represents a Peon number. Okay. So again, for a given value of x, for a given value, as you see, as you have seen from the diagram, we may have infinitely many values of sine inverse x. Infinitely many values of sine inverse x. So sine inverse x is a multiple valued function. Sine inverse x is a multiple valued function. You see, for a particular value of, in the diagram, go to the diagram, you see for a particular value of y, you have infinite number of x, that is the angles. X is representing here the angles. So here sine theta, theta is the angle. So how will you write the angle? Sine inverse y. So there are infinite number of values of sine inverse y. Or you say sine theta is equal to x, so there are infinite number of values of sine inverse x. So sine inverse x is a multiple valued function, but sine theta is a single valued function, because for a particular value of theta, you have only one value of sine. That is, sine theta is a single valued function, sine inverse x is a multiple valued function. So this is the basic introduction of inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, now the deeper concept of the inverse function is that the question is that when does the inverse function exist? The inverse function exists when f is both 1 1 and onto, otherwise the inverse does not exist. You know, if the function is bijective, in that case only the inverse function exists, otherwise the inverse function does not exist. Okay, so let me draw another, I will draw several diagrams. So before you go to the, just look at to the definition of inverse. So f is a function from a to b. So you see, f is a function from a to b. F is a function from a to b. And y is a function of x. This is y, this is x. Y is a function of x, such that f is both 1 1 and onto, that is f is injective as well as surjective. So that is why f is called bijective. Then there exists a unique function g from b to y. That is, in that case you will find a unique function. If it is a injective and surjective, in that case you will find a unique function g from b to a. You look at that, g from b to a, such that y belongs to b implies, that is, y has a pre-image in a. Y has a pre-image in a if and only if y is fx, then g is called the inverse of the f, and it is denoted by f inverse. G is denoted by f inverse. So this is the definition of inverse. And also, f inverse composition f will give you the identity function. F in f of a if inverse y will give you the y. So this is the basic concept of inverse. And when does the inverse exist? When the function is 1 1 and onto. Okay, now let us come to the most important part of inverse. What is the graph of the inverse, and where you will see the inverse function in the branch? So let me explain first. Suppose if I draw the sine curve, so let me draw the sine curve. This is your sine x, it's just like a wave, this side also. So you see, if I ask a question to the, all of you, that is it a 1 1 function? No, the result will be, the answer will be no, because for 1 1 how will you check 1 1 function? If you draw a horizontal line, that will curve, cut the curve at exactly one point, but that is not so. If you draw the horizontal line parallel to x axis, it will cut the graph at so many infinite number of points. So this is not 1 1, that is the that is violating the conditions for 1 1. So what we'll do, we will take a branch of the graph where it is 1 1 and onto. So let's take a branch of the curve. If you see, if you have, you have to take the branch of the curve. Suppose if you take this portion, that is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, only this portion, if you cut this portion, then you see, if you draw the horizontal line, it will cut the graph at exactly one point. Then in this branch, the graph is 1, 1 and onto. And obviously, if you take another branch from minus pi by 2 to pi, sorry, this is plus pi by 2. From pi by 2 to pi, And if you draw the graph, if you draw the horizontal line, it will cut the graph at exactly one point. In this case also, this is 1, 1 and on 2 because it cuts the graph at exactly one point. If you take the negative side, minus pi by 2 to minus pi, then also this follows. So you have to take the function of the graph of sine x is sectionally 1, 1 on 2. It is sectionally 1, 1 on 2, not throughout 1, 1 on 2. Okay. So I will take the only the principal section, and nearest to origin is called the principal section of the graph. So I will take the only the principal section of the graph. Let me draw the inverse of that graph only. Again, let us draw the axis. Okay, x axis and y axis, and let us draw first the sine curve. Only that portion. You look at that, I have drawn only that portion of the graph, that is lies between minus pi by 2 and plus pi by 2. This is minus pi by 2 and this portion is, this point is pi by 2. Okay, so I am considering only this portion, and I will draw a straight line y equal to x. Okay, this is your y equal to x line. This is your y equal to x line. So let me this is okay. Okay, now what is your sine inverse x? Sine inverse x is nothing but the reflection of the curve sine x in the mirror y equal to x. So if you consider y equal to x as a mirror, if you consider y equal to x as a mirror, then sine inverse x is nothing but the mirror image of y equal to x. Look at that. Your red line, your red curve is the sine inverse x. Your red curve is the sine inverse x, and blue curve is the sine x, and blue curve is the sine x. Okay, your red curve is the sine inverse x and blue curve is the sine x. So it's very easy to draw the diagram. How you first draw the branch of principal branch of sine x, that is which lies between minus pi by 2 and pi by 2, and then you draw the sine inverse x. Sine inverse x, and then you draw the y equal to x line, that is the line y equal to x, and y equal to x you consider as a mirror, and y equal to sine inverse x is nothing but the mirror image at y equal to x, mirror image at y equal to x of sine x. Okay, you see the red curve is the sine inverse x. So what is the domain and what is the range? So it's very easy, because you see the domain of sine inverse sine x, the domain was sine x is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, and what is the range of sine x? What is the range of sine x? 1 to minus 1, that you know, everybody knows about that. So let me write that. What is the domain? I am writing here, what is the domain of sine x? Because you are considering only minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, that branch only. And what is the range of sine x? As usual, the range will be minus 1 to 1, because sine x, cos x all like confined between minus 1 and 1. Now, what is the domain of sine inverse x? You see, the domain of sine inverse x, the curve sine inverse x is much steeper. So, you see this point, you look at that video, you see this is the point. So, this point is minus 1 to 1. So, this domain becomes domain. So domain is minus 1 to 1. And what is the range? What is the range? Range is, you see, what is the range? What is the minimum value and what is the maximum value? You see, this is your maximum value. So this is your pi by 2. And this is your minimum value. This is your minus pi by 2. So range is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. That is, domain of sine x becomes range, and range of sine x become domain of sine inverse x. So, okay, this is how you will draw the sine inverse x. Sine inverse x, first you take the branch of sine x, principal branch, especially the principal branch. So, you consider principal branch of sine x, that is the first branch, which is lies in minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. because why you are taking this branch, because this is in this range, it is 1 1 and on 2, and you draw y equal to x line, then you draw y equal to sine inverse x as a mirror image, that is a reflection on y equal to x, and you calculate the domain and range of sine inverse x from the graph only, from the diagram only. So let's now consider cos inverse x. So let us first draw cos x. Let us again draw cos x. So you see cos x is, you see this is your cos x. Cos x is, if you see where cos x is 1 1 and on 2, you see cos x is 1 1 and on 2 in the range 0 to pi. In the range 0 to pi. Why? Because if you draw the horizontal lines parallel to x axis, horizontal lines, then it will cut the curve at exactly one point. So that is the, without any calculation, that is the observation from the graph that whether it is 1 1 or on 2. Now let us draw y equal to x line, because any inverse function you have to draw, that is nothing but the mirror image at y equal to x. Now you draw y equal to cos inverse x, that is you take the mirror image of this blue graph, mirror image of this blue graph. So let me take the mirror image of this portion. This is the mirror image of left hand side of the graph, upper part, and now you take the lower part. Lower part will be like this. So this is your graph of cos inverse x. So red graph is your cos inverse x. Red graph is your cos inverse x. So what is the domain of cos inverse x? What is the domain of cos inverse x? The range will be the domain. So you see minus 1 to 1 is the domain of cos inverse x. You see this is your, that means this portion, if you draw the point here on the x axis, drop the perpendicular, this is your minus 1 and this is your 1. So your domain is minus 1 to 1. You see your domain is minus 1 to 1. And what is your range? Range is this one. Range is minimum value and the maximum value. So you see 0 to, and this point is pi. This point is pi. You see your range becomes domain, domain becomes range. So your range is 0 to pi. Your range is 0 to pi. Okay, clear all of you? So this is how you will draw the cos inverse x. Okay, so in that case also you take, so cos inverse x is also sectionally 1 1 on 2. So you take that section, that is 0 to pi, that is the principal section, and draw that branch only 0 to pi. Draw the line y equal to x, and draw y equal to cos inverse x, which is nothing but the mirror image at y equal to x. Okay, and you calculate the domain and range from the graph only. Next we'll draw tan inverse x. Okay, so for tan inverse x, let me draw, and you know that tan pi by 2, tan minus pi by 2 is undefined, so we will take the only that branch only. Okay, so let us draw tan inverse x. It will be like this. This is your tan inverse x. Next draw y equal to x line. Okay, this is your y equal to x line. So your, this is your y equal to x. Always your blue curve is the main curve, so y equal to tan x is blue curve. Okay, and what is your tan inverse x? Tan inverse x will be the mirror image, mirror image on y equal to x. So it will be like this. Sorry, so tan inverse x will be like this. Yeah, just like this. You see, it's like a mirror image. It's like a mirror image. The branch of this branch, this upper branch, and this is the image of the lower upper branch, and this is the image of the lower branch. So red curve is your tan inverse x. Red curve is your tan inverse x. So it's like an increasing function. Okay, and what about the domain? You see your domain is minus infinity to infinity. The whole real line is the domain. So your domain is R. Your domain is the real number. And what is your range? Your range is, you see, your range is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay, your range is minus, open brackets, open intervals. Okay, this is your minus pi by 2 this is your minus pi by 2 line. So if you draw this, this is your minus pi by 2 and this is your pi by 2. So it's confined between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, and domain is the whole real line. Whole real line is the domain. Okay. So next we'll talk about cot inverse x. What is cot inverse x? Cot inverse x, let me draw the cot inverse x. It's very easy. If you can draw tan x, then you can draw cot inverse x also. Tan inverse x and cot inverse x are very similar. So in cot, if you see in cot, this is the because tan is slanted on the right side and cot is slanted on the left side. So this is the cot, and if you draw the y equal to x line, similarly, because always if you want to draw the inverse, you draw y equal to x and take a reflection. So you take the reflection of this, so it will be like this. Yeah, this is the cot inverse x. It's decreasing. One observation is that tan inverse x is an increasing function, but cot inverse x is decreasing function. And what about the domain? Domain in this case also, domain is R d of f, that is domain. Domain is the whole real line. And what is the range? Range is your 0 to pi. You see, there is no negative branch, so it lies between 0 to pi. This is your pi. This is your pi line. So 0 to pi, and this is your y equal to 0 line. So it lies between y equal to 0 to pi. Okay. So all of you, please try how to draw sec inverse x, how to draw cosec inverse x. So I will just give you a hint how to draw sec x. You should try for, suppose for sec x, you have to draw the cos x. This is your cos x. Okay. And how will you draw sec? Sec will be on the upper and the lower. This is your sec. The red line is the sec x. I am not drawing inverse. So you just try to draw the inverse. This is as per your assignment. You explore yourself. So this upper and the lower portion, this red, are the sec. So there are multiple curves, infinite number of branches. And you know, also you know, that modulus of sec x is greater equal to 1, because you see sec x are greater than equal to 1 or less than equal to minus 1. You see, these are the less than equal to minus 1 and these are the greater equal to 1. So actually cos x lies between minus 1 and 1, but sec x is more than, modulus of sec x is greater equal to 1. That means sec x is more than equal to 1 or less than equal to minus 1. Similar explanation for cosec also, and you try to draw sec inverse and cosec inverse. Okay, let's have some problems on. I hope after this drawing graphs, I think the concept of inverse function is clear. Let's have some problems on inverse. So first problem is cosec inverse true. Okay, let me give you idea of what is the value of sine inverse half. If you want to calculate what is the value of sine inverse half, so half means whose value is half? Sine pi by 6. 30 degree is half. Okay, so if you write sine pi by 6 is half, so if you take the inverse, then what you have? Sine inverse of half is your pi by 6. So sine inverse is an angle. As I mentioned earlier, the sine inverse something is an angle, and sine theta is a value. Sine theta is a value for a particular value of theta. But sine inverse x is an angle, and sine inverse x is multiple valued function. Sine theta is a single valued function. Okay. So what is the principal value of sine inverse half? That will be your pi by 6. Okay. Let's have some problem on, more problems on that. What is the principal value of cosec inverse 2? So let, you can start like this, you can calculate like this. Let cosec inverse 2 equal to y. So what is your cosec y? Cosec y is 2. Cosec y is 2. And what is the value of 2? Cosec pi by 6. Cosec pi by 6. So what is your and you see what is the range of the principal values of cosec. Cosec is range of principal values of cosec is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, except 0, because cosec 0 is undefined, except 0. So this value pi by 6 lies in this range. So the principal value of cosec inverse 2 is pi by 6. So principal value of cosec inverse 2 is pi by 6. Clear? Next, what is the principal value of tan inverse minus root 3? Again, you suppose this is your y. So tan y is minus root 3. Okay? And minus root 3 is nothing but your minus tan pi by 3. Okay? And that is equal to tan of minus pi by 3. All sine tan cos, if you observe. So tan of minus pi by 3. And tan of minus, what is the range of tan? What is the range of tan? You see, just I have drawn the diagram here. You see, what is the range of the tan inverse? Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So your minus pi by 3, minus pi by 3 lies between minus pi by 3. You see, your minus pi by 3 lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So that belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So this is your pi by 3. Okay. So what is the principal value of tan inverse minus root 3? Minus pi by 3. Clear? So this is how you will calculate the principal value. One more problem is there. Cos inverse minus 1 by root 2. What is the cos inverse minus 1 by root 2? Again, you assume it y. So cos y is minus 1 by root 2, right? So it is minus cos pi by 4. Okay. And what you can write from all sine tan cos? Cos of cos is negative in the second quadrant. So you write cos of pi minus pi by 4. Pi minus pi by 4. So what is the value? This will give you cos 3 pi by 4. This will give you cos 3 pi by 4. And you have to check what is the range of cos inverse x. What is the range of cos inverse x? 0 to pi. You see, let me show you the diagram once again. Yeah, you see 0 to pi. Okay, 0 to pi. So is your angle 3 pi by 4 lies in this range? Yes. So 3 pi by 4 belongs to 0 to pi. So your principal value of cos inverse minus 1 by root 2 is 3 pi by 4. This is your answer. Okay. So before you answer the question of the principal values, please make sure that your calculated value lies in that specific range that is mentioned. So you have to remember the ranges of the values. You have to remember the ranges of the values of cos inverse x, sin inverse x, tan inverse x, cosec inverse x, sec inverse x, cot inverse x. Okay? This is how you have to calculate the inverse. Next, I will use some properties. There are some important properties of sine inverse functions. Very, very important properties. So first property is that sine of sine inverse x is x. Sine of sine inverse x is x. So sine of, if you find sine of sine inverse x, then that will be x, provided that x is in, lies between minus 1 and 1. So that means you can't write sine of sine inverse 2 that is equal to 2. No, this is not equal to 2. Because 2 is not a number, lies between minus 1 and 1. So this formula is valid for minus 1 to 1. So cos inverse cos x is also valid for x equal to x belongs to minus 1. So if you draw the small diagram for that, this is nothing but your y equal to x line. This is nothing but your y equal to x line. Okay, this is your sine of sine inverse x. And you see, this is lies between minus 1 and 1. This is minus 1 and this is minus 1. So x is between minus 1 and 1. So this will give you sine of sine inverse x is x. Okay. Similarly, tan of tan inverse x is x. X belongs to R for any real number. For any real number, there is no restriction. Any real number, you can do that. And cot of cot inverse x for any real number. Also, cosec of cosec inverse x is x for all x belongs to that range. Minus infinity to minus 1, you know that I told you that cosec x, modulus of cosec x is minus greater equal to minus 1. So it's minus infinity to minus 1 and 1 to infinity. For sec, this should be sec. So there is some printing mistake. Please make a correction of that. This should be sec of sec inverse x. This should be sec of sec inverse x. That is also this range. Okay. Next is property 2. What is your property 2? Sine inverse sine theta is theta. Sine inverse sine theta is theta. For theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So sine inverse sine theta is theta. For all theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So I will show you this diagram once. Let me assume, let sine inverse sine theta equal to y. So what will happen? You know that we can write this is as sine y equal to sine theta. Okay, and from the general values you can write y is equal to n pi plus minus 1 whole to the power n into theta. N pi plus minus 1 whole to the power n into theta. Okay, now for n equal to 0, for n equal to 0, what is the diagram? Let me show you the diagram. Let me show you the diagram. For n equal to 0, that is the principal branch. Then that is your theta. That is y equal to theta or y equal to x, say. This is the diagram. If you say this is x, then this will be y equal to x. Because for n equal to 0, this is 0, minus 1 whole to the power 0 is, so I am assuming theta equal to, or let us suppose theta for your understanding. So y equal to theta. For n is equal to 1, for, so for this is for n equal to 0. For n equal to 1, how will you draw n equal to 1? This is pi minus theta. So pi minus theta is this one. This is your pi minus theta. So this branch is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. But this is your minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. But this branch is lies between pi by 2, this is pi by 2, and this is your 3 pi by 2. This is your pi by 2 and this is your 3 by 2. So on, you can proceed. You can take n is equal to minus 1. You can take n is equal to plus 2, 3, etc. So this goes on. It's like a mountain range. Okay. So this is the diagram of sine inverse sine theta. But sine inverse sine theta is theta when theta is in the principal branch. When theta is in the principal, that you see from the graph, this is your principal branch. But this is pi minus theta when it is pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. And this is your all other values. This is your minus pi minus theta. Okay. This is your 2 pi plus x. That is 2 pi plus theta. This is your minus 2 pi plus theta. And so on. And so on. So these are the values. Only value theta is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Only when it is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Clear? Similarly, we can show from general values like this calculation. We can repeat and we can show that cos inverse cos theta is theta for all theta belongs to 0 to pi. For all theta belongs to 0 to pi. You can try this by this considering these general values. You have learned the general values in your class 11. So from that knowledge, you can draw the diagram and this just like a straight line. Just like a straight line. Okay. These are all straight lines in that particular range. Taking n is equal to 0, taking n is equal to 1, taking n is equal to 2, taking n is equal to negative values also, you will get this. But you have to remember that sine inverse sine theta is theta when theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Next is tan inverse tan theta is theta when theta belongs to the open interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. cot inverse cot theta is theta when theta belongs to 0 to pi. So these ranges comes frequently. These are the very important concepts. Also, cosec inverse cosec theta is theta when this is the range, and sec inverse sec theta is theta when this is the range. Okay? So you have to carefully note it down. Next set of formula is property 3 or formula. Sin inverse of minus x is minus sin inverse x when x lies between this range minus 1 to 1. Cos inverse minus x is pi minus cos inverse x. And cot inverse minus x is pi minus cot inverse x. And sec. For cos, cot and sec, that will be pi minus. And all other cases, it will be simple minus only. Okay? Cos, cot and sec. This is property 3. Let's come to property 4. That is the sin inverse of reciprocal of 1 by x, that will be cosec inverse, provided that x belongs to this range. X belongs to this range. Cos inverse 1 by x is sec inverse, provided that x belongs to this range. And tan inverse 1 by x is cot inverse x when x greater than 0. This is very, very important. Please take a note of that. And you can find the proof in any book. Cot tan inverse 1 by x is cot inverse x when x is greater than 0. That is all from graphs only. You can explain everything from graphs. Tan inverse 1 by x is pi minus minus pi plus cot inverse x when x less than 0. So when x is positive, it is simply cot inverse x. But when it is negative, it is minus pi plus cot inverse x. Also, property 5 is very useful in problems. Sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is pi by 2. For all x belongs to minus 1 to 1. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is pi by 2. For all x belongs to r. And sec inverse x, cosec inverse x plus, this is also pi by 2, x belongs to this range. Okay, these are also important. And just you see, you have a relation. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is just like this formula you have learned. You would have seen that tan a plus b is tan a plus tan b. Tan a plus tan b by 1 minus tan a tan b. 1 minus tan a into tan b. So this is also, you see, the formula is look like this. X plus y by 1 minus xy. Just like tan a plus tan b by 1 minus tan a tan b. So x plus y by 1 minus xy. If xy greater less than 1. If xy less than 1. Before you apply this formula, check that your x and y is less than y. Product of x and. Suppose it is tan inverse half and tan inverse 1 fourth. You can apply this because half into 1 fourth is less than 1. But if xy is greater than 1, then this formula pi plus, and if all of them are positive and if all of them are negative, then you apply minus pi plus tan inverse this. Okay, if xy, that is in the first quadrant, and xy greater than 1, it will be pi plus, and if it is xy less than 0 and xy greater than 1, then it is pi minus pi. And for negative also, you can explain by yourself. This is the formula: tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. So this is your chapter. There are a lot of formulas when we do problems on that. When we solve problems, you can see, you can calculate all this. There are a lot of things that to do with the problems. So these are the main important structure of your inverse calculus. Okay, inverse trigonometric functions. So thank you all of you. This is my video lecture today.